Hey guys, welcome back to Your Lake Fork Guide, another episode of the Guides Network. Today we're going to go over one of my more favorite offshore hot summer techniques. We're going to talk about catching them on a swim bait on a jig head offshore. Hey, before we get started in today's instructions, I want to let you guys know about something. I've been wearing these Waterland glasses for quite some time now, most of the year this year. Couldn't be happier with them. The best copolymer lenses I've ever put on my face. Oh yeah, and they've got an unbelievable price point. They have them on sale on their website at waterlandco.com, which you can find linked in the description. Also, when you go there, check out that sale price, then punch in that code, Your Lake Fork Guide, get a 10% discount. You're gonna get these glasses as good as any I've ever worn for a little bit over $100. So best deal on high-end eyewear on the market that I've seen in maybe ever. So you guys go check that out. Also, before we get started, a lot of the stuff you'll hear me talk about today will be sixthsensefishing.com, the jig heads, some of the swim baits, the rods, a lot of the stuff. Hey, sixthsensefishing.com, as always, linked in the description. And also, when you order something there, you can also punch in the code Your Lake Fork Guide to get a 10% discount on anything you might want to order. Just our way of saying thank you to you guys for watching the channel. All right, so let's talk about offshore fishing, and specifically let's talk about swim baits on jig heads. You know, there's a lot of different ways to catch fish offshore. A lot of dragon baits. We got one getting caught offshore right now on a Carolina rig, I think. Barrett, what are you catching that one on?
Carolina rig.
Barrett's got a Carolina rig fish. Barrett, you're crowding my space, dude. What are you doing? You got a whole, you got a 20-foot boat and you're in my hip pocket, son.
It ain't a bad fish.
Well, I'm sure it's not. Let's not make a showboat a good night, son. That sucker turned south on you, didn't he? What's he doing? Come on, bring him to me. I'll catch him. We'll play catch.
You want
him? We'll play catch. Come on. Oh, good Lord. That's a big one.
You might say so.
Oh, Barrett, you had him stuck too, son. You had him good. Bone stuck him, boy.
Got him pretty good.
Must be with them 6-inch hooks.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Regular. Mr. Barrett with a stud. Give me your scratch for you, Barrett.
Give him a little scratch.
Here, I'll let you let him go. That's a beautiful fish, my man. Good job. So before I was so rudely interrupted by my customer today, young Mr. Barrett came out, 14-year-old young man, came out here and absolutely shackle-jacked him with me today, didn't you, buddy?
A little bit.
We've been wearing on him pretty good. I think you need a new cricket on your hook.
Yes, sir.
But anyways, as I said, there's a lot of different ways to catch them offshore. Carolina rig, what he just called, another great one. Deep diving crankbaits, a lot of ways. One of the best ways to get, as we get later in the summer, the temperatures get hotter. These fish will start to rise off the bottom a little bit and sometimes scatter out a little bit. One of the best ways to cover a lot of ground and really draw a bite from a fish that might be off the bottom, might be on the bottom, kind of cover a wide variety of depths, and really a bait that has drawing power that will take those scattered fish and draw them together is going to be the swim bait on a jig head. That's one of the reasons I like it so much as we continue to get hotter and hotter. Water temps out here today are in the upper 90s, folks. We have absolutely scalding hot water. And that swim bait just takes these fish that are wanting to scatter and suspend a little bit and draws them together. And if you saw the video on Monday, you saw us sit there and catch them over like fish after fish on one spot once we found them. So it's a really good tool to take fish that don't really want to bite, or maybe you might catch one here, one there, and be able to draw them together and really get them going and catch a bunch all at one time. All right, so let's talk about how we're setting this up. There's kind of a couple different options for your swim baits on your jig heads. One is going to be the underspin head. Okay, and I love those. And the other one is going to be just a straight jig head. You can see the two different options right here. There's also two different swim baits I throw on. This is the 6 Sense Divine swim bait in the 4.4 size. That's Pro Shad. I also like Electric Shiner. Those are my two favorite colors. A lot of good colors to choose from though. And this is the Smash Tech Hollow Belly on the underspin head. I will throw either one of these swim baits on either one of these heads. They're totally interchangeable. When the fish are more active and really a little more aggressive, I like the hollow belly because the entire body really vibrates. It has a really fast action. So when the fish are a little more aggressive, then I'm gonna throw the hollow body. As the water temps get hotter and hotter and those fish are a little bit less apt to bite and a little bit more scattered out, I'll go to something like this so that I can fish it slower, reel it slower, keep it in their face longer. That's when that bait really comes into play. The problem with fishing these two different styles of jig heads, they look very similar, but if you look at one thing, the hook is completely different. These are both half ounce heads, but the hook is just completely, completely different. The underspin heads always have a thin wire hook. The jig head, especially the 6 Sense Divine jig head, both of these, by the way, are 6 Sense swim bait jig heads. The 6 Sense Divine swim bait head has a really beefy hook. Therefore, your rod, reel, and line setup has to be completely different for these two options. Let's talk about the big boy first. The big boy, and this is the one that I prefer to throw when I can, and I'm gonna tell you why. It's because I can throw it on a bigger rod and bigger line, and I can take more control over the fish. But on the big guy right here, this is a half ounce jig head. This is a 7.5 medium heavy Divine series rod, great rod. I also throw it sometimes on the 7.7 heavy Century series. That rod works really well for it as well. And then of course I'm using that rod, or maybe even sometimes my 7.8 heavy Divine series, when I'm throwing the 1 ounce or 3/4 ounce jig heads that have the even bigger hook. That 1 ounce jig head that I throw the bigger hollow belly on, it actually comes with a like 7-aught hook. So it has a huge hook. So you need a really big rod to drive that hammer home. The general rule of thumb is the heavier gauge, the thicker the wire on the hook, the more rod, the more line strength you're gonna need. For this one right here though, the one we're talking about today, the half ounce jig head, I'm using the 7.5 medium heavy rod in the Divine series from 6 Sense Fishing, of course. For line, I'm using 20-pound fluorocarbon 100% of the time. Mr. Barrett got broke off today on one. Probably wouldn't have got broke off if he had 20-pound fluorocarbon. He had 15-pound line on his rod, and one broke him off on this exact setup right here. So you got to be careful. Make sure you got enough line to handle that big hook and these pretty dang big fish we're catching out here. You know, one of the things that is important in your setup is going to be your reel speed. I'm a big proponent of throwing high-speed reels and just slowing down when I need to slow down. It is pretty difficult to keep this bait down. You really have to focus on how slow you're reeling the rod. You got to keep your rod tip down. Sometimes you got to fish them so slow. And that was 100% the key for us to get our first few bites and really get these fish going, was to keep that bait down in their face for a long period of time and really fish that bait extremely slowly. For that reason, I actually do go down to like medium gear ratio reel. I go down to a 6.3:1 when I'm throwing these swim baits on jig heads. All right, now let's talk about the underspin head. Like we said, much thinner wire hook. Okay, and the hook sets are also gonna be different on these two baits, and we'll show you those here in a minute. The setup on this, I'm actually gonna throw, you can throw a 7.1 medium heavy, or I really like the 7.4 medium heavy Century series. It seems to be perfect. I like that little extra length, a little extra leverage. But you need a rod that has a lot of bend to it, okay? Because you're really gonna kind of reel into this and pull into this hook set with that thin wire hook. You don't wanna go getting over ambitious on your hook sets when you have the thin wire of the underspin head. I'm actually going to use 15-pound fluorocarbon on this setup because I do have that thinner wire hook, and I'm trying to keep that bait down as much as possible. Not only does this rise because of the swim bait, but also the blade on there is going to make it rise even more so than the regular jig head. So I'm using 15-pound line, and I can get away with it because I have a lighter action rod and I have a much thinner wire gauge hook. Reel, same deal. I want to go 6.3:1 on my reel. Like I said, it's a struggle to keep it down there in their face. And here's the package that you guys are looking for. If you're looking for the 6 Sense Divine swim bait, this is the Pro Blue color, 4.4-inch size. Pro Shad color is the name of the color. But that's what the package looks like on the website for 6 Sense Fishing. All right, so there's the setup. So let's talk about the area. And this is where it can start to get a little more complicated this time of year. When these fish start scattering and suspending a little bit, they can get off the sides of structures. You really have to spend a little more time on your graph. You have to be a little more open-minded as to where you look. The bigger lake you're on, the harder it's going to be to find some of these fish because they have more options to get out and spread out. But the whole key is checking those prototypical summertime structure spots. Humps, row beds, pond dams, points, anything with a small top and a sharp drop. A little feeding platform, a good drop off on the side of it where they can change depth angles frequently. That's going to be what you're looking for. The most important thing though, as far as areas go, is just to find the fish. Sometimes they can be in the middle of a flat. You have to be really open-minded. Like, you can't just graph the whole lake, obviously, but when you're graphing a piece of structure, graph a little bit outside of it. If you start seeing fish, really zigzag and dial in that area and really hone in and try to find those fish off of the structure, like relating to it kind of, but really off the structure. A lot of time, those are gonna be your top secret fish that nobody else is throwing a bait at. When they get out there, scatter and suspend, and they're not right on the structure, those fish do not get messed with near as much as the fish that pull right up on the structure do. So if you see that, you see a good grouping of them, you can usually get them to bite that swim bait. All right, guys, I'm gonna talk to you about how to retrieve this bait and also the hook set, which is gonna be different. First one we're gonna go over, like I said, is my preferred one. This is gonna be the regular jig head with the big beefy hook, the half-ounce jig head. All right, first thing you want to do is make a long cast. The whole advantage of this bait is these fish are spread out. They're covering a lot of ground with how they're spread out and suspending and scattered. So the advantage of this bait is that you can cover all that water. So make sure you're making a long cast. Next thing you're going to do is strip a little line and let that bait fall straight to the bottom. Okay, we've got our bait on the bottom. So we're going to point our rod down towards the water and we're going to very slowly reel. Again, the key component to this time of year with this slower one, is to go ahead and keep that bait in their face as long as possible. So we're going to point a rod down real very, very slowly. Now, one thing about all swim baits, any way you rig them, any way you fish them, they'll hit it and not get it quite a bit. Like you'll feel bump and there's nothing. The key deal to catching those fish that are bumping it and not getting it is to just keep reeling at the same pace. Don't stop reeling. So when you feel bump, just keep coming. Just keep coming. And just keep reeling until you start to feel a little bit of load. As soon as you start to feel a little bit of load on this one, the big jig head, not the underspin. On this one, when you feel that load, go ahead and drop your right foot back, big swinging hook set all the way up here to your right shoulder, and drive that hook home as hard as you can. There's a big heavy gauge hook on that thing, so you can swing that hammer, my man. And of course, once you've got them hooked up with this deal, you know, once you get that bend in that rod, keep the bend in the rod. If he comes to jump, stick your rod down in the water pointing away from him. Try to get his mouth full of water and just kind of horse him to the boat and boat flip him like you guys saw us do on Monday, actually. Now, if those fish are suspending off the bottom, okay, it depends on how high they're suspending off the bottom. This bait's going to fall slightly faster than a foot a second. So I'm going to give it a kind of a little bit of a quick count. Let's say I've got fish suspended 5 foot down. So I'm going to make a cast and I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now I'm going to point my rod straight out and reel nice and slow. Just a nice, steady, medium retrieve. That's gonna keep that bait pretty close to that. It's gonna keep them really close to the right depth. It's gonna be about 5 foot under the surface the whole way home as long as I maintain this rate right here. If the fish are suspended way down on the bottom, I'm gonna go ahead and cast my bait out there and let it go all the way to the bottom. I mean, not way off the bottom. If the fish are suspended like 5, 6, 7 foot off the bottom, which a lot of times this time of year will be the case. When that's the case, I'm gonna let that bait get all the way to the bottom. Once it's all the way to the bottom, I'm gonna lift my rod up, I'm gonna crank it about 4 times, and then I'm gonna point my rod down and do the medium retrieve again. So I'm gonna let it get all the way to the bottom, crank it up 3 or 4 cranks real fast, shoot it up off the bottom, then start medium retrieving. That's gonna make that bait glide through that water column they're in at some point. It's gonna spend a long time in that depth zone they're in if you do it just like that. All right, let's talk about the underspin head. Again, much lighter rod, much lighter line, much lighter wire hook. The beginning is going to be the same. Again, same principles about keeping the bait in their face a long time, same principles about making a long cast, covering a lot of water. So we're going to get this bait on out there, strip a little line, let it sink. Now once this bait's on the bottom, okay, it's on the bottom. Now remember, this bait has even a little more lift than the regular jig head. So you really got to concentrate on keeping this bait down. You're not going to be able to, especially if you're fishing the hollow belly. The hollow belly has a faster action, so you have to fish it a little bit faster. But if you have the Divine Swim bait on this one, you can still keep that slow action. But you really have to concentrate on keeping that bait down and slow rolling it to keep it down on the bottom. So the principles of this are basically going to be the same. Now the difference is this one's going to fall slightly slower. It's going to fall right at a foot per second. So if you have suspended fish 5, 10 foot down and you want to count it down, just count 1001, 1002, 1003 to the desired depth. Then the same medium retrieve should keep it at about the same depth. Everything you're gonna have to do on this is just gonna be a little bit slower. The fall rate's gonna be a little bit slower. The retrieve's gonna need to be a little bit slower. That blade adds that little bit of extra lift to that where you're just gonna have to be a half step slower on everything to keep it in the same depth principles. So the biggest difference between these two baits is gonna be 100% the hook set. You know, we told you to do a big hook set on the regular jig head, but on the underspin, that's not really what you wanna do. Again, though, you'll feel them bump it, not get it, bump it, not get it. You just keep it coming. And you really have to concentrate on reeling until you feel a load on this one. As you're reeling, when you start to feel a load, you want to just kind of start pulling. And you don't really want to jerk, you just want to pull. Like you can pull hard, just don't jerk on it. if that makes sense. So really use your reel hand to engage it and really use the pull of your rod. So I'll kind of show you what I'm talking about. So right here, if I was going bump, okay, it starts to load, I'm gonna pull and really burn that reel handle a lot, which my hand slipped off the reel. That would be a disaster if that was a real fish. Thank goodness it wasn't. But this one, once you get that rod dug in real good, just kind of take your time with the fish on the underspin head. Maybe don't boat flip them all, especially if it's a big one, because you do have that light wire hook and that smaller line and all that. We actually boat flipped one and grabbed it by the line earlier and it broke off because we have 15-pound line. So those mistakes can happen. You're going to need to take your time a little bit more, be a little bit more careful when you're fishing the underspin head. Nice. Grabbed them up, caught them up. Ain't no biggin. Ate that little old squid bait on that jig here. Come on in with the big head. Eating that swim bait, boy. Oh, that's a nice one, babe. Good job, buddy. Oh, get him in. That's a big, and that's the biggest one yet. Uh-oh. Just a little fella right there. Not a bad one, though. Yo, big jump. Big jump. That's like, it looks like a smallmouth. All right, guys, that's it, man. That's our talk on fishing offshore swim baits on jig heads. Hey, I certainly hope this helps you catch more and bigger fish. We caught a mess of them on it today. I've caught a mess of them and some really big ones over the years doing it. So get out there and try these principles out and see if they don't help you catch more and bigger fish. Thanks for watching. Barrett's about to catch another one, maybe. And we'll see you next time right here. Catching Barrett on your Lake Fort Guide.